Hello Chellu, welcome to our third session of this chapter. Here we have learnt that the 0th year is the birth of Christ, that is the Christ year when Christ was born. Now BC or BCE and AD or CE. Now what it means we will know now. BC stands for before Christ. So all dates before the birth of Christ are expressed in BC and they are counted backwards like 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 1 and 0 is the Christ year, the birth of Christ on the 0th year and then we move in a positive direction. So the BC years are counted backwards. For example, 273 BC, it means 273 years before the birth of Christ. It is normally written in small capitals and placed after the numerals as in 500 BC, not BC 500. So we write BC after the numerals to show the year. Now BCE stands for before common era. Now instead of writing BC, we can also use the term BCE, which means before common era. Like 273 BC can be written as 273 BCE also. Now we come to the next term AD. AD stands for the two Latin words Anno Domini. That means in the year of our Lord, that is Christ. So Anno Domini are the two Latin words that are used as AD and which means in the year of our Lord Christ. All dates or years after the birth of Jesus Christ are expressed in AD. These years are counted forwards. Now after the year birth of the of Jesus Christ's birth, the term AD is used and the count goes forward, that is in 1, 2, 3, 4 in this direction. For example, 2018 can also be written as AD 2018, that is 2018 years after the birth of Jesus Christ. To find out the difference between two dates that are either both in BC or both in AD, we subtract the smaller date from the bigger one. For example, the time difference between 2000 BC and 500 BC. So we subtract, it is the time period of 1500 years. Similar is in the case of AD. It is as the same in the case of AD. Now on the other hand, to calculate the time difference between two dates where one is in BC and the other is in AD. So we add the two dates. For example, the time difference. Now look here, I'll explain it to you in more detail. So here is the time line and here we have the 0th year and it is set 500 BC. So here we have the 500 BC. And we have 1500 AD. So how many years will be there? Now if you take these years and this year. So addition of these two will give you the total difference between these two years. That is 2000 years difference is there. Now AD is generally written in small capitals and should be placed before the numerals as in AD 400 and not 400 AD. The reason being AD is an abbreviation of Anno Domini, which means in the year of our Lord. However, when the date is spelled out, it is normal to write the 2nd century AD, not AD the 2nd century. So CE stands for the common era. Now AD can also be termed as CE, which means common era. That is, we can write 2018 AD 2018 or 2018 CE. It stands for the Latin word circa, which means approximately. It often precedes a date, for example, C 1947. Now we use another term, that is BP. Sometimes BP, that is before present, is also used to denote past events. Now what is the purpose of these time denotations? That is, the term BC and AD are used. So these terms are mentioned to denote the time of happening of a particular event or events. So this is the purpose of denotation of the time. Now they also indicate the historical significance of events and activities. They have a lot of historical significance, a lot of importance regarding the historical events and activities that have taken place and that might have taken place in our previous years. So BC and AD determine those time period. Now for the convenience of study, we can say AD 2000 or 2000 CE as the present age. In the same way, we can say 2000 BC or 2000 BCE. It is used to indicate that a date is before the Christian era or the Common Era. So this is what we have learned today, and we have known a lot of things about the importance of AD and BC. So why should we write AD and BC? This is what the purpose is, just because it has very many historical significance of events and activities that have taken place in history. And it also denotes the time of happening of any particular event or events. So this is what is in this chapter, and hope you have known a lot of things. So now, learning time, and happy learning now.